The gym may be closed today, but we can still get a little bit of a workout in. Let's start seated. We'll warm up from the bottom up this morning. Your feet straight under you. Scooch to the edge of the chair. Sit up nice and tall. Bring your shoulders back to check in. Notice what's going on in your body this morning. You want to stay in a pain-free range of motion where nothing hurts. Listening to your body. Let's just start by bringing your toes up. Just bringing them up and down. Just paddling the toes. Nice and easy. Stay. Good morning. Those shins. Lifting them up and bringing them down. Two more times. And two. Let's bring the toes up. So we're standing up on the toes. And then bring up on the heels. So coming all the way up on the toes. And back to the heels. We'll do 10. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And go at your own pace. If you're not at 9, that's okay. Step those legs in and bring the knee up. And roll that ankle. Go in the clockwise direction at first. And then going in the opposite direction. So counterclockwise. Just little circles. Warming up the ankle. And rocking it from side to side. Invert and invert. Like ringing the bell here. Ding, ding. Just rocking that ankle, keeping it loose. And we can stay steadier on uneven surfaces. And it has a good range of motion. So set that one down, bringing the opposite leg. Making circles in a clockwise direction at first. Just rolling it. Make them great big as much as you can. And then rolling in the opposite direction. Ringing it like a bell, bringing the toes in, or rocking it in and out, and in and out, inward, inward. Just finding a good range of motion in that ankle today. See what's comfortable. What's working, and it's head down. We're gonna do one more hip opener. We're just gonna bring the legs in and tap it out. Hip bob there. Bring it in, tap it out. See what's going on in your hip joint this morning. In and out. We'll do like three on each side. We'll come back to this motion, so keep this in the back of your mind. We'll be using it a lot. Just in and out. In and out. In and out. Alright. Two more. One on each side. Alright. Get the legs moving. Let's move the hips. Just do it as if you're hula hooping. It's just a seated hoop. Coming around. And you bring them back into it. Make those circles as big as you can. I'm shifting weight in the seat. Great big circles. Notice what's going on in your back and your hips. Those big circles. Now this time as you come forward, bring the heart forward, lean a little bit forward. Let's get a little curve in the back. We're going to see the cat cow. And then rolling the back as far as bringing the chin towards the chest, rolling the back of the back down. And forward. Reaching forward. And reaching back. Flexing the spine, keeping that space. Opening across the shoulders, helping the posture. Mm-hmm. We're going to bring the arms into it now. As you come forward, bring the arms straight out in front of you. Bring the hands together. And then bring them back. Maybe we slow that down a little bit. Bring the hands together as far as you can get them, and then bring them back. Just find which emotion is comfortable for you. As you round and round. Bring them back into it, open wide. Two more. Open wide. I'm going to drop the arms down and then sweep them all the way up. Maybe you cross them, bring as far up as you can and bring them back down. Sweep them up, look up at the ceiling, reach up tall. And look down as you look down. As the arms come down, look up at the ceiling and then drop the chin down. Looking out. Excellent. Just going as comfortable as it is, as far as comfortable this morning. Got any shoulder issues, and this is as far as you want to go today? That's as far as you need to go. If you can, bring the hands together, let's interlace them in the front, and push them up towards the ceiling. Again, finding that place that works for you. Try to keep the back straight, the shoulders down, and push up towards the ceiling. Up if you can. Lengthen the other side. And then bring your arms down and let them go. And one more time, float them across the center. Interlace them, this time in a way that feels awkward. And then look up at the ceiling. Push up to the hands. Look up. Bring that chin to the chest. And then slowly bring it back. Side of the chair with your right hand. Let's take that left arm up and lean off to this one side. Or maybe stretch, pushing out through the palms. Maybe look up under your arm. Finding a stretch here, just lengthening the whole side body. And then float the other arm up, letting go of the side. Bring the left hand down for stability. Look up at the ceiling. Nice and tall. Look up under the arm if you can. And float that left arm down. Bring the right arm across into one twist. Bring the right arm. Some days. Bring the right arm across to the knee. Left arm around behind you and twist. Look back behind you. Just allow the spine to twist. Sit up nice and tall. Maybe bring the chin back towards the back, looking a little bit behind. And then release. Bring the left arm across to the right knee and the right arm behind you into a great twist. Looking back. And come on back, in front of you. Remember I said we were going to come back to this tapping. That's what we're going to do. We're just going to go out and in. And then we'll add on. We're going towards some standing things. So coming in, add out, in, add out. Count the rhythm of that. Just tapping in and out. Warming that up. Now we're going to add on. Tapping in, tapping out. We're going to tap out, in, out, and in. So right leg out, left leg out, right leg in, left leg in. So out, out, in. We're stepping in and out of the car. Use this leg to step up big and tall, and out and in. Stepping over a curve. Make great big movements. Come out, bring it in. Got it. There it is. Out and in. All right. Adding on. Out, out, in, in. This sit back down carefully, you know where the chair is. Then go out, out, in, in. We're gonna do that three times, and then stand. Out, in, in. So that's two. Out, out, in, and stand up. Good. And find the chair and slowly sit back down. Out, out, in, in, out, in, in. Next time we stand up. So out, out, in, and stand up. Stay here a second. We're gonna do that out, out, in again, but let's just get warmed up. So we're standing, just moving from side to side, just shifting your weight left and right. We're gonna step out a little bit wider. Stepping, tapping. Shift your weight. Now we're gonna bring it in. We're gonna do the out. We've done this one now. Out, in. So just getting your rhythm. Notice your coordination today is out and in and in. Let me get some music together then. Out, in. Out, in. We're going to add on. And we've done this movement too. We're going to add the big arms. So out, in. Bring the arms together. Out, in. Arms together. In. See if you can keep the movement going as we add the arms on the third time. So one more time. Out, in. Arms. Out, in. Out, in. Arms. In, out, in. Check your coordination today, that gets tricky. In, out, in. Arms. Out, in. Out, in. Out, in. Arms. In, out, in. Arms. All right, let's set that up. So we've gone from side to side. You're getting in and out of a car. So stepping up and over. In, out, and in, right? Just like you're stepping the car. So we've gone sideways. So let's go forward and back like you're stepping over stuff the kids left. So just stepping forward and back, shifting your weight, stepping over the Legos, the little train stuff the grandkids left. Just shifting weight. That's all we're doing. Stepping forward, stepping back, just shifting the weight, checking in on the balance. We've always got the chair here if you need it. So just got out and back. That's simple. But you know we're going to add on. So back and forth. Back and forth. Bring the knee up a little bit, bring the heel up a little bit. We've done this before. Forward and back. Forward. Up a little higher, a little higher than me. Up and back. Up and back. You got it. So the knee's coming up. Heel's coming up. Great big movements. Checking in this balance. You know we're going to add on. So the next time we come up, step forward. Just stepping forward just a little bit. Just lunge into that, just a little bit of a lunge. Got that little step forward. See if you can reach up like you're reaching for something off the shelf. So reaching high, bring that arm back down, straighten the leg. And then lunge one more time, sweeping up, sweep the arms up. I actually one more. One more time. Sweep the arms up, reaching high. Excellent. And then come back to center. We're just going to step through. So now we've shifted sides. So let's just start with rocking, going forward and back. Get the balance and the rhythm again. Forward and back. Forward and back. Let's bring the knee up. Bring the heel up. Knee up. Heel up. You got it. There it is. Knee up. Knee up. Up and back. Up and back. And we're doing the left side. Back. Always feels a little different depending on which side you're on. Up and back. You got it. There it is. Two more times, coming up front, up, and then we're gonna step into that lunge. So up, step a little bit forward. You're pushing through the back foot, if you can see the back foot. If you can, use the same side arm and reach out. But if you want the chair there, reach up with the other side, that's good too. Let's reach up. And straighten that leg a little bit. And bend it a little. Just bending and straightening the knee, listening to what the knee is telling you today. Yeah. And down. Excellent. And then let's come back. Stepping forward left. Bring the knee up. The right knee up. Right knee up. Heel up. Knee up. Heel up. Knee up. And come back to marching. So we've gone forward, we've gone sideways. Let's try some diagonal. Then we'll sit down, call it. So we're gonna step sideways and forward. So you're going off to about 11 o'clock and back. Same movement, just on a diagonal. So we're gonna add the arm swing. So forward and back, forward. And just again, going in your range of motion, what feels good. Chair there for balance if you need it. If you're feeling tricky, you can raise both arms. But not required. All right. So we're going to shift around to the other side. And start with marching. We're going to go off to the diagonal. So we're at about 2 o'clock. Stepping right. Off to about 2 o'clock and come back. Stepping and coming back. And the heel and the knee. Bring it up as high as it'll go. Big emotion and you can make it. Again, stepping over the master grandkids mat. Stepping up, stepping back. Watching. So you can look up and forward while you're doing this. Eyes are up, you're standing up tall. And the arm. And the arm up. And back. So you're gonna feel tricky. Two more. Back and front. Tap the knee back. Or toe back. Let's let that go. And shake the feet out. Let's sweep the arms up to 90 degrees. A little bit more stretching. We'll call it for the day. Let's bring the left hand over to the right. Right across the body. And open it out wide, bring the heart forward, bring the shoulder blades together. And sweep down the back. Open wide. And sweep it back. So come forward, the shoulder blades come together, the heart comes forward. You go across, try and bring the elbows close to the other elbow as it can. It probably won't get there, that's good. Go where you can go. But bring the elbow back, or you want to bring it to 90 degrees. You're coming right across the body. Not as important to get the elbows together as it is to get the stretch in the shoulder. That's where we're going. Just making a basic shape. Coming across the body, stretching the shoulder blade out. Bringing it together. Opening it out, let's let it down. Sweep the arms up. Great big circles like you're swimming. Great big backstroke. See how far these shoulder blades will go. Good rotation. Then just bend them out, arms up to 90 degrees, and let's just make circles with the elbows. Great big shrugs, keep the shoulders down, but in that joint. What's going on in there? Arms out, rotating the hands up, reaching towards the ceiling with the palms up, push out, stretch long, see if you can get wide, spread the fingers out, push through the palms, and then roll the hands down so they're facing the floor, extend out through the fingers, so the fingers are up and wide, and maybe roll them a little bit back. Going on in your shoulder joint. Reach towards the ceiling, push out through the palms, really activate through the hands. And then roll them back down. Maybe a little bit behind. Sweep the arms up. Palms up to the ceiling, the thumbs are back behind you. Then roll that thumb down to the floor, maybe a little further back. And then release the tension in the arms and let's just roll into that shoulder socket. As far as the arm or the shoulders will allow, drawing circles with the thumbs. So the thumbs can go up and down, all the way around. And let the arms down. Just shake those out. Let's walk the feet out on the floor. A little bit wide apart. And maybe the feet are flat out. Maybe they're up at 90 degrees. Let's do it at 90 degrees, actually. Bring the knees to 90 degrees. Sit up nice and tall, drop the shoulder blades down. We're gonna lean down over your knees the first time. We're just gonna lean over. Just a nice forward bend. Maybe your hands walk down, maybe they sat on your shoulders or on your knees. And then roll the back up, roll up through the back, and come back up. Again, breathe the heart forward and rolling down. Pause for a minute here, allow the back to release and set. Rolling back. Rounding the back, coming back up, dropping the shoulders one last time, going forward like this, coming down. Oh, shoulders. Shaking back up through. Awesome. Now with the hands on your knees, let's take the feet out just a little bit wider. Sit up nice and tall. Bring the shoulder blades back. We're gonna take the right shoulder to the left knee. So maybe your feet need to be a little further apart. But just see if you can find there's a little bit of a twist and a little bit of a stretch here. It's coming across on that diagonal. And then come back up. And that elbow, I'm reaching over towards that knee. Pushing down so you can bring the elbow over to meet the knee. And come back up. Maybe your feet get a little wider and you can push out through that knee, a little bit more resistance, a little bit further into the stretch. But you decide what's good, what feels right. Come back up and come to the other side. And go at your own pace, finding the perfect stretch for you. And come back up. One last time on each side, coming down. Coming back up. Last one, left side. A little bit in the back. shake it out. Bring the feet in. We just want the feet out in front of us. And stretch a lot on the back on these last ones. This is one of my favorites. Just walk the hands down the legs, stretching them out, keeping the chin on, folding at the hips, and just allowing the back to stretch all the way up through the back. Bring your hands to wherever is comfortable. Maybe walk all the way down your legs, maybe down on the floor. Just finding that place where you're stable. You've got enough room on the chair. There it is. And find a good stretch there. And then walk on back up. Come on back up the legs. Bring the legs back in. Take a deep breath in. Just let it all go. Sweep the arms up. And thanks for practicing with me today. Hope you enjoy.